Hello, Superherd, and welcome back to Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. And today we're going to be going in and checking out what Rux has in store for us. Now, I've already heard a lot of what people are saying about this Rux, so I'm not going to be too surprised, no matter if it is good or bad. I guess I'd be more surprised if it was one than the other, but we're gonna be talking to him and seeing what he has to sell. It is a legendary hat. At least we have that. And then of course we have two classic items, a rare scrumptious item, and then a special infinite item. We are of course going to spend our money on the infinite alien Crashsite for the Citron, which is weird because I just showed off a legendary Citron hat last episode. Interesting thing about this is, like, first off, this is our first unique item from Rux in a little while. Last time we had Rux, no unique item whatsoever. This time we at least have a legendary hat. No ability still. We haven't had an ability from Rux since May, which just stinks in all sorts of levels, and I'm sure I'll talk about throughout today's video. But this is one of the cheaper legendary hats we've had. Now, that could be for a few reasons. One, maybe they're confident that it's not that good of a legendary hat. That's sort of the, bad situation, the bad result, or it could just be that they're trying to make it cheaper so that we can afford maybe a more important Rux coming up. Either way, we'll go ahead and check out this legendary hat. I'll talk about my thoughts about Rux throughout today's episode. But for right now, where is this hat? Right here. It is the alien Crashsite, and it looks like it's some kind of alien, of course, has crashed on Citron's head, and his UFO is all beaten up. He has a fire extinguisher. He looks so weird. It's so hard to see him. He just gets cut off, so that's sort of weird. We'll go ahead and enjoy him. I probably will be playing more Electro Citron. I know I played Electro Citron in the previous episode, but hey, we still almost have him mastered. He's still a fun class. I hope nobody really minds too much, but if you do mind, stay tuned till tomorrow or the day after. I should be doing the community challenge, which I won't spoil for right now. It's a really cool one. Go ahead and check it out for yourself. I haven't looked into it specifically, but it does include a character that a lot of people like, and that I like a lot too. So for right now though, let's go online, enjoy this legendary hat, and see what the legendary effect might be. Okay, I had to wait around for like 10 plus minutes to finally find a match where I could play as plants, but we are on, of course, Moon Basie. We'll be taking the moon, hopefully. I better do better this episode than I did last episode with Electro Citron, but I don't even see who's shooting at me, so that's not a good start at all. Yep, I don't see him. It's way too far of a distance for me to see. There's probably people with better zooms sniping at me. It definitely is easier to see down this lane as zombies than it is plants. But yeah, I can't wait to see what this legendary effect is. And, you know, like I was saying before, it is cheaper than our average legendary hat for Rux. Typically, they're about 500,000. In the past, they've been up to 1 million coins for legendary hats from Rux. I definitely prefer 300K. I don't think it needs to be as much as it usually is. Okay, start back up a little bit, maybe? I pressed my shield button. I don't know what's happening. I pressed my shield button, like, as soon as I noticed him. Nothing really came of it, but our Rose friend here got our back. I will say that the community challenge does have to do with roses, so we're probably gonna see a lot of those today. Whenever I'm not playing the objective when a community challenge is out and about, I always feel bad. There we go. Wait, okay. Well, that's not anything too spectacular. Basically, it looks like he is using his fire extinguisher to put out literally no flames. Okay, that's really weird. I don't know if I like that at all. So, obviously he's holding a fire extinguisher because obviously his ship broke down, but it would be even cooler if maybe the ship sort of burst up in the flames and he starts, you know, frantically putting that out instead of just splurting it for, I guess, really no reason, right? That just doesn't make any sense. I don't know, I feel like it's an okay hat, but it definitely could be better. It could be better just by a little bit of extra work. All they would have to do is slap a fire texture on there. That's all they would have to do. Just as soon as you get a vanquish, boom, fire texture, and then he does that animation, and then the fire goes out. That would just, even that little touch would make it a little bit more charismatic. So, not a big fan of that so far. Is it the worst in the world? No, I do like the little smoke effect. I'm sure it's not the worst legendary hat, but I don't know. I'd almost, when it comes to me, maybe I'm just picky about things. I'd almost rather have a bad legendary hat than a potentially good legendary hat, but isn't because of lack of effort or foresight. Does that make sense? It's like, when something has a good potential, I'm like, oh, it could be so much better. But when it's bad, it's just bad. And you're just like, whatever. Maybe that's just me being weird because, you know, I am sort of unorthodox. I'm a zebra who plays games for the internet. But hey, we're gonna go this way. So I didn't want to just go ahead and mirror everybody else's thoughts on stuff about Rux. Of course, I've already talked about it. If you guys didn't see the episode Last month on the Hot Beans Legendary Hat, I talked a lot about Rux, my thoughts on why he hasn't been selling as many good items and what this could mean for PvZ, so I don't want to mirror my own thoughts. I also don't want to just be reflecting on what everybody else has said. There's plenty of other Guard of War for community members who have been expressing their thoughts on Rux, and I don't want to just sort of sound like another drop in the ocean. So instead of, you know, talking about why I'm upset about it, I figured we'll keep on talking about why maybe it's happening, because I don't see too many people bringing that up. And it's sort of a 50-50, you know? And it's especially for the situation, because it is frustrating, right? Because typically a legendary hat is something to get excited for, but only if it's to let us keep our appetite up for abilities or something more important. The legendary hats should be the filler. But the legendary hats have been all we've been getting at most for the last month, and for the last 4 months, we haven't gotten a single ability. And I've talked about that in the Hot Beans episode before. Could it be that, you know, they are building up for something more? Maybe they're going to have a huge supercell blowout. They had that back in May, which was the last time we've seen an ability. They also had that back in Thanksgiving, around November, the end of November, they had an event where they just sold a bunch of legendary and abilities. Yeah, I think like Rux was fully stocked and for some pretty good deals too, if I remember correctly. And that was also the same time that the boss hunt, the Brothers Gnomus boss hunt debuted. So that was a pretty cool time to be a Guard of War for a two player because there was just a lot of cool stuff there in Rux. And maybe they're saving up for that. Maybe they are going to have a huge blowout. And that's sort of where the 50-50 of my prediction comes. We're doing it okay so far. Five egg, which is not anything crazy. But I think that one or two things is happening now. And I've talked about one of the two things, but the first thing is gonna be, maybe they're saving all of the legendary hats and all the abilities and all the remaining PvZ heroes hats for something more important. Maybe soon there will be a new Plants vs. Zombies game announced, and they are going to save all of this legendary and awesome stuff for one huge sale that will keep us interested and exciting in God of War Fern long enough and hyped long enough to be excited for the new game. If there is a new game. And why I think that might be the case, and it's a loose assumption, so like don't take this with anything more than a grain of salt. If not anything, maybe a half a grain of salt. Gamescom is coming up. If you guys don't know, Gamescom is a gaming conference. It takes place in Germany, and PvZ, PopCap, and Garden Warfare specifically has made an appearance in Gamescom before. Back in 2013? Yeah, 2013, when Garden Warfare was originally announced at E3, at Gamescom in August of 2013, they showed more gameplay of Garden Warfare. And they did the same thing in Gamescom of 2015 with Garden Warfare 2. They actually revealed some gameplay. So PopCap and Gamescom has happened before. So could we expect that again? Gamescom happens, I think, August 25th. We're coming up, only a couple days away. Could we see something PvZ related? It's happened in the past. They've never announced a new PvZ game at Gamescom, as far as I know, but it's possible. I don't see why it would be impossible. But it's definitely a loose assumption because they've only revealed information about PvZ games, new maps. I just keep on hitting my controller against my desk. Super clumsy today, I'm sorry, but yeah, they've only revealed, you know, new information about PvZ2 or Garden Warfare related stuff at Gamescom. They've never revealed an entire game there. But hey, maybe this is a turning point. But maybe it isn't. Maybe things aren't going so well with the next game they're making. We don't really know what the future of PvZ holds. You know, maybe EA isn't as happy with PvZ and as PopCap as we might think they are. And maybe their relationship is, you know, suffering. Who knows? Because that could definitely be something. A lot of people don't realize that publishers are involved, and with Plants vs. Zombies, as if any video game, money is involved. There's people to be paid because everybody, you know, who works on a video game, it takes a lot of time and effort. It's a full-time thing. You know, everyone wants the next Garden Warfare or Plants vs. Zombies. It takes a lot of time and money to do that kind of stuff. And what if EA isn't interested? Maybe they weren't happy with how Garden Warfare 2 performed, or how maybe some of the recent PvZ games in general have performed, PvZ Heroes or PvZ 2, and they're pulling back funding, making it even harder to make another Plants vs. Zombies games. I mean, I'm not saying that's what's happening, but I'm trying to, you know, keep an open mind here. That's definitely possible and has happened the previous games, you know, in other genres and similar genres. It's happened in gaming. So it wouldn't be an impossible thing. And it's the sort of something, you know, that could be happening. I'm gonna destroy you if I can. I cannot. I'm definitely going in a bit too close for comfort, for my own comfort and for theirs, because they're very easily vanquishing me. That's just not how Electro Citron should work. I did get to level 7 though, which means only a couple more levels to go to level 10, and then we got this bad boy mastered, and I don't have to worry about him for a little bit until our top 10 video, which will probably be a long ways off. But it has been hard to keep motivation to keep playing Garden Warfare. Like, I enjoy the game, don't get me wrong. But, of course, as a YouTuber, my main goal is to keep relevant and to keep you guys interested as much as the Zebra Herd interested as possible. And I know a lot of you are interested in Garden Warfare, but I've even seen a lot of the core community start taking interest in other games. And that's totally fine, that's sort of the way gaming works. But that's why I have been posting less Garden Warfare videos. It's been harder for me to level up my characters because I'm also trying to find time to play other games to make sure that the Zebra Herd is as happy and as growing as much as possible. But I still play Garden Warfare. Honestly, I've been playing much more PvZ Heroes. It's just been a lot more cared for. The game is always evolving and being interesting because there's always a new card being added every week. And if you play PvZ Heroes, you know how much the meta can be shaken up by just one or two event cards being added. I feel like Garden Warfare could have benefited from that, and in some way, they were setting that up. If you were to release a new ability twice a month or even once a month, that would shake up the game a lot, and I feel like that was their idea, was that PvZ Heroes' weekly event cards was supposed to parallel with Garden Warfare's monthly abilities, but something didn't work out for Garden Warfare, and I honestly think it's either that their new game is coming up and they want to sell a bunch of abilities to hype everyone, or it's taking way longer and it's way more difficult than expected, so they need to stretch it out as far as possible, which is why we might have to wait several months before even just one or two abilities. I mean, only time will tell, but we should keep talking about it probably in the next round because I'm rambling. All right, our second chance with this legendary hat. Can we get to the end of the round? Probably not. I haven't seen the end of Moonbase C in a little while now, so I'd like to see it. It's always fun. I think, honestly, Moonbase C is probably the most failed map I go on when it comes to actually getting to the end. Yeah, I think so. What is the one that I get to the end? The most high, sir, you every time. I figured maybe you'd be on my team now. Not quite. Okay, you're running, you're scared. Once again, I'm pressing my shield button. It's like my R1 broken. I don't know, because I keep pressing my shield button and just it's not popping up. Yeah, let's see, pulled up now. Yeah, just fine. I don't know, maybe if you're attacking, it doesn't work. Now, of course, I just canceled my shield, but it was worth checking instead of in the middle of battle. Maybe if I'm attacking, my shield animation is delayed or something, which would be totally bogus. I am gonna go ahead and do that to you, sir. Where'd you go? Right here. Boom, boom, boom. Get you. Oh, you're jumping everywhere. Oh, I am so awful with the Electro Citron, and I need more space is the thing. Not exactly getting it, but I got like no experience there. Towards the end of the previous round. Oh boy, get you. Gotcha. But it has just sort of been a little bit more difficult to record Garden Warfare recently, just because I don't feel like I've had enough to talk about the game. I mean, usually I try to drone on about all the things I could be excited for the future PvZ, and you know, my thoughts on what's going on right now, but when there isn't too much going on, it's really just hard for me to find a lot of stuff to talk about. And of course, I'm able to do the same thing in other games. Like I said, I've been playing a lot more PvZ Heroes than I have in Garden Warfare 2. I play PvZ Heroes on a daily basis now, and I've been trying to get my rank up, and it's a lot of fun. It's really intriguing for me. But Garden Warfare, I've really been only playing to either earn my 2x experience for a video or during recording for the video. What do you know? I do enjoy that I'm having a vanquish streak. Where are you? You are sneaky. Whoever, wherever you are, goodbye. Well, I'm gone. I definitely have not been playing well the last couple episodes because I haven't been playing often, and I don't know. That's just how it is. Especially since I have been playing characters like Super Brains and Citron that I'm not exactly the best with. You know, I'm not, you know, exactly bad at Electro Citron or Cosmic Brains. Not Cosmic Brains. Well, it's Cosmic Brains, right? Yeah. I'm not exactly bad at those characters, but I wouldn't say I'm the best ever. Can I sneak up to you? I don't think I can. But somebody else got you. We're making our way through level 7. I got a decent amount of stars. Most of those I earned up earlier today, like I said, earning up the experience. Oh boy, oh boy. Let's try to get that. But I do suggest you watch through my Hot Beans Legendary Hat video that we posted last month. If you do want more information or my thoughts on what might be happening with Rux and what might be happening to the future of Garden Warfare 2, I talked about it a lot in that episode. I don't want to repeat myself over and over though. I mean, I know maybe you don't want to listen to that video, you just want to hear me drone on here. I mean, that's fine. I don't hold it against you. And I'm dead again. We got this point though, so I should be responding right here. So it might just be worth doing that, unless this person revives me. They will. Okay, thanks, I guess. But yeah, soon enough though, I will be making a video on the new community challenge. I know I missed last week's super mix mode, which was sunflowers versus something. Was it healers versus healers? Might have been. Sunflowers versus scientists or something. But unfortunately, I've been having a rough month. I've been pretty sick. I haven't had the chance to record too much. But I'm trying to bounce back again. The end of July was really great. I feel like actually the end of July was actually one of the best couple weeks for the channel I've had so far. And then August has just been tough so far. And I've talked about it on Twitter and stuff. I've been doing my best. I'm getting beat up here. But I did destroy a couple things, which is good. All right, where are you at? Oh, I got that. That was good. It's really about predicting their movement, which is incredibly difficult to do. But if you can do it, it works out really well. Okay, I see you over here. I got you. That was good. Sometimes I just need to take more time than I actually end up doing. I keep on seeing him, you know, puff the smoke from this fire extinguisher all over the place, and it makes me think there's somebody attacking me. Oh my gosh. It is pretty much a distracting hat. A lot of the hats are distracting though, so I'm not gonna hold that one against it. Okay, they know I'm here. They're holding that one against me. Okay. We'll try to go around the left side unless this person's gonna try respawning me, which I don't think they are. Yeah, they don't look interested. No, they can't because they're not alive. That's fine. We'll go around the left way. We got a lot of experience in the last minute or two just by taking our time aiming up and trying to predict our shots a little bit more. Nope, that didn't work. Okay, that was good right there. Just gotta take my time. Oh, that was good. That was good. Look at that. See, I'm starting to get a hang of it again. Getting back into the mojo. I see you shooting at me. But you're just a tiny little dot on my screen, which I don't appreciate. Become larger, scientist. You get taller. Eat a Super Mario mushroom or something. Okay. Oh, I see you in the air. Oh, I got you. That was actually a pretty good shot. Oh, that was good too. The thing is with the Electro Citron is that I'm definitely way more visible than a lot of these guys. Our hat is going off like crazy though. I can hear him. He sounds cute. He makes some gleeful noises. I just wish to have had a little bit more love into it. And that's sort of the, I feel like that's more than anything, I feel like that's been a big issue with the game, is that sometimes some of the legendary hats we've been getting, some of just the treatment to the game in general, it's just sort of felt, I don't wanna say soulless, because I feel like that's a little too harsh, but I feel like there definitely isn't as much love of, like a labor of love in it as there normally is when it comes to legendary hats, when it comes to the game in general. When Frontline Fighters was coming out, when Trials of Nomus was coming out, oh my gosh, it just felt like there was so much care and detail put into every corner of the game. And same thing when the game just launched. And I feel like you can definitely say the same thing about the original Garden Warfare as well. It just felt like there was, you could feel the passion with everything. There was always so much fun to be had. And you just felt it. The art style was there, the motivation was there. But recently it just feels like, for whatever reason, that's missing. And you can tell through legendary hats like this, it's good. But it feels like it could just very easily be better if they just took the second to hang back and say, how could this improve? You know, I want this to be the best hat I can make. How can I make it better? And just like, oh, add a little bit of a fire texture. That only takes a couple seconds, right? I mean, this guy right here is literally burning. To use that same texture, you know? Wouldn't be that big of a deal. And they already have the fire textures for every single fire class. Oh boy, I'm gonna sneak on over here and it would be a very simple thing to do. Like, look at that, there's another fire texture. They're all over the place. They definitely have the assets available. I don't see how it would be a tough thing to do. I mean, maybe I'm wrong though. Once again, I'm not a game maker. I make YouTube videos and I make, you know, YouTube thumbnails, but I'm not a game maker. It's a totally different field. But I try to, you know, express what I know. And that's just my input. Of course, you know, that's all it ever is. I'm never trying to, you know, act like my choice and my ideas are better than whoever made the game, because chances are their ideas are better because they can make a really fun game and I can't. But I feel like, you know, even if you don't make a game, you can understand what makes a game fun. There you go, we got you a little bit. I'm glad that that does disrupt the cannon. At least I am glad about it when I'm playing Citron. Not so glad about it when I'm playing Captain Deadbeard. Okay, we got one of them. We're doing okay though, 17 vanquishes is pretty nice. Much better than what we've been doing recently, so. But I haven't asked you guys, what are your thoughts on this legendary hat? Maybe I'm totally full baloney and you like the hat. I would love to hear. Have you bought it? I do think it's at least fair that it's only 300,000 coins. I wouldn't mind if we had a legendary hat every month as long as it was, you know, this cheap. Because I feel like 300,000 is the sweet spot. I feel like 500K for a legendary hat is definitely too expensive. Back when they pushed 1 million for a legendary hat, definitely way too expensive. I think 300K is just the right spot because, to be honest, a lot of the other stuff in Rux has always been too expensive. I think that, you know, having to cough up 150,000 coins for a scrumptious hat, I honestly will never ever wear. Unless it's like a one-off situation where maybe I just wanted to give my character all scrumptious items. Chances are I'm never gonna wear any of the scrumptious or infinite items that I buy from Rux. I just buy them because I want to one day be able to complete the game and get all the items. It just feels like filler content, and that's totally fine. Every game has filler content, especially in an online game like this, is gonna have filler content. That's unavoidable. But don't overprice the filler content, because then it just feels like, you know, you're cheating us. At least that's my feelings with it. I mean, maybe I'm just not a big fan of scrumptious, and a lot of people aren't. I mean, look at this guy. He's rocking the scrumptious hat. He looks really cool. And maybe it was worth 150K to him. And that's why opinions are important. I feel like a lot of people, you know, they'll throw their opinions out there, but they won't take in many. And so it's hard to get a good idea about what people think. And I think if we all share our opinions and, of course, are nice about it, you know, we can think things differently, but still be able to respect each other's opinion. That's sort of what gets some positive ideas around. I mean, at this point, I do love Garden Warfare 2, and I wish that this game would get support. But I would be interested to see PopCap export PvZ in different ways. You know, I've talked about that many times before, and they have been doing that with PvZ Heroes is a great example of how they've been using Plants vs. Zombies, and instead of just turning it into a puzzle game or just a shooter game, they're turning Plants vs. Zombies itself into a franchise. A good comparison would be like Super Mario. Super Mario is not just known for his 2D or 3D platformers, he's known for his sports games, his kart racing games, you know? He's known for just about everything, his party games. He's not just a game character, he's not just a platforming game, he is an entire franchise. And I feel like that's what they're trying to do with Plants vs. Zombies, and I think that's a totally good thing because it means we get more games and more interesting topics covering our favorite plants and our favorite zombies. And I think that's, they really hit the nail on the head with that with PvZ Heroes. Because honestly, I like it just as much as I do the PvZ normal games and the Garden Warfare games at this point. I've really fallen in love with the game. I'm definitely awful at it, and there are some times where I definitely feel frustrated with it, but it's not a bad game whatsoever, and if they just keep trying, I mean, PopCap, definitely one of the most creative game teams, in my opinion, or at least at this point, in this day and age, probably one of the most creative developers out there, right up there with Media Molecule and Naughty Dog, in my opinion. They're probably my top three right there. My top three favorite game developers are PopCap, Naughty Dog, and Media Molecule. But for right now, I think we've shown off plenty into the legendary hat. We had some fun, decent vanquishes towards this last round, and we got to talk a little bit about Rux in the future PvZ. I'd love to hear your thoughts on all of it. As always, discussion is good, discussion is fun, and maybe throughout the weekend, maybe I could earn up enough coins to get all these scrumptious infinity and classic items. Who knows though, it's always a toss up for me. But that's gonna do it for right now. So there's our look at the Alien Crashsite Legendary Hat. Had some good ideas going on, but ultimately the execution could have been a little bit better. But for 300,000 coins, if you're trying to get every Legendary Hat, it's not that bad of a deal. It, you know, like in this episode alone, we've earned up 50,000 coins. So I think you get the idea. Either way, thank you guys so much for watching today's episode of Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. If you watched this point of video, be sure to comment Alien Zebra so I know you've watched to the end and that you are a Zebratastic viewer. If you enjoyed today's episode and you want to see more like it, feel free to click on any of the videos on your screen right now or subscribe to join the Zebra Herd. Either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.